Hello everybody, now we are going to see solution of today's IIT test. Okay, first question is, if the coordinates of a point are 0 minus 4, then it lies in, okay, it lies in y axis because its x coordinate is 0. Okay, so it will lies in y axis. Second question is, if the coordinates of a point are 3, 0, then it lies in x axis because its y coordinate is 0. Okay, question number 3 is, the section formed by horizontal and vertical lines determining the position of the point in a Cartesian plane is called, okay, is called quadrant. Due to this, okay, each of this part is known as quadrant. Question number 4th, which graph is parallel to x-axis? Which graph is parallel to x-axis? Y is equal to 2, this graph. Because if y is equal to 2, then the coordinates will come 0, 2. Okay, 0, 2. And you will plot if 0, 2, then 0 will come here and 2 on the y-axis. So it will come here, 2. And you will get like this parallel line. Okay, so y is equal to 2 is the parallel line for this. Question number 5, which point lies on x-axis? On x-axis, that is 2, 0. Okay, so here suppose you will see 2, 0 means the point is going to come here 2 and this is here. Okay, and this is x-axis. So this point lies on x-axis. Question number 6, which point lies on y-axis? So 0, 3. Okay, here only we can see 0 and 3. 0 and 3 will come here on y axis. Okay, so 0, 3 point lies on y axis. Question number 7 is, which point lies to the right of y axis? Which point lies to the right of y axis? So C is the correct answer because this way it will come 3, 5 means on x axis suppose 3 is here and y axis it will come here suppose 5 is here. Then this point will come here like this. Okay, 3, 5. So it is right to the y axis. This is y axis, right to the y axis. So C is the correct answer. Question number 8. Abscissa of all the points on the x axis. Options are 0, 1, 2, any real number. Okay, so correct answer is any real number. Correct answer is any real number because see, abscissa of all the points on the x axis, so any real number can come. Question number 9, which point lies on the left of y axis? Okay, left of y axis, so -2, -4. Okay, -2, -4, this point will lies on the left of y axis. Question number 10 C, which point lies in fourth quadrant? Question number 10 is, which point lies on lies in fourth quadrant? So 2, -4, because in fourth quadrant here positive and here negative, so plus minus it is going to come. So this B is the correct answer. Question number 11, 3x plus 10 is equal to 0 has unique solution. Only one solution you will get because 3x is equal to minus 10. X is equal to minus 10 by 3. Okay, unique solution. Then question number 12. Question number 12 is, the solution of equation x minus 2y is equal to 4 is. So correct answer is C. Why C? Carefully. X is equal to, suppose we will choose this, x is equal to 4 minus 2 into 0. 2 into 0. Okay, so 4 minus 0, so 4, and which is equal to the RHS. Okay, so C, 4, 0 is the correct answer. Question number 13, find the value of K if x is equal to 1, y is equal to 2 is a solution of the equation 2x plus 3y is equal to K. Okay, just we have to put the values 2 into 1 plus 3 into 2 is equal to K. So 2 plus 3 to the 6 is equal to K, 6 plus 2, 8. Okay, so D is the correct answer. Okay, question number 13, D is the correct answer. Then question number 14, 0.34 lies on the graph of the equation 3y is equal to kx plus 7. The value of k is, okay, just we this is x and y or coordinates we have to put here. So 3 into y is 4 is equal to k into 3 plus 7. So 12 is equal to 3k plus 7. So 3k equals to 12 minus 7. So 3k is equal to 12 minus 7 is 5. So k equals to 5 by 3. So B is the correct answer. 14b. Then 15. 15 is the graph of linear equation x plus 2y is equal to 2 cuts the y axis at. Okay, so here C is the correct answer, because if you will put here 0 1 x is equal to 0 plus 2 into 1, so it will come 2, and which is equal to the RHS. So C is the correct answer. Okay, now question number 16. Question number 16 is the graph of x is equal to 3 is a line. The graph of x is equal to 3 is a line. That answer is B, parallel to the y axis at a distance of 3 units from the origin. The graph of x is equal to 3. X is equal to 3 means it will come like this. X is equal to 3 means y coordinate is 0. So 0, 1, 2, 3, suppose 3 is here. Okay, so what is second point says parallel to the y axis, parallel to the y axis at a distance of 3 units from the origin. This is 3 units from the origin. Okay, 1, 2, 3, because its point is given x is equal to 3. So B is the correct answer. Question number 17, the graph of the linear equation y is equal to x passes through the point y is equal to x. Both are same, means obviously 1 is to 1, 1 and 1, y and x are same. So these both the values are correct. Okay, now the pair of equations y is equal to 0 and y is equal to 7. Okay, y is equal to 0 and y is equal to 7. Suppose you will see here in Cartesian plane, y is equal to 0 means x is equal to 0. So that point will come here. Okay, then y is equal to 7. So x is equal to 0. So 0, 0 and 7. So 7 supposes it is here on y axis. So it will come here and that line will come like this. Okay, so the pair of equations, both lines are not intersecting to each other. So there is no solution. Okay, D, no solution. If lines will intersect, then there are solutions. There is a solution of, but here lines are not intersecting, lines are parallel, so no solution. Question number 19. Aruna has only rupees 1 and rupees 2 coins with her. If the total number of coins that she has is 50 and the amount of money with her is rupees 75, then the number of rupees 1 and rupees 2 coins are separately. Okay, so that answer we have to find out. So see carefully, let the number of rupees 1 coin be x, number of coins, okay, and number of rupees 2 coins be y. Okay, how many total coins are there? There are 50 coins. So x plus y is equal to 50. This is first equation. Okay, and secondly, what they have told us, the amount of money with her is rupees 75. Amount of money with her rupees 75 means amount here, and these are number of coins. So how many coins are there of rupees 1? X. So we will multiply here by 1. So what you will get? 1 into x plus how many coins are there of rupees 2? Y. Rupees 2. So we will multiply the 2 into number of coins, and the total amount is 75. So this, suppose I will say equation 1, this I will get x plus 2y is equal to 75. This I will say second one. Okay. So now by subtracting second from first, so what I will get here, see, x plus y is equal to 50 and x plus 2y is equal to 75. So here I will do subtraction, then x we can cancel. So this sign is going to change, minus this also it will change. So plus x minus this will be cancelled, plus y minus 2y will be minus y is equal to minus 25. So y equals to 25. Okay, so y 25, then we can put this here in any equation. So here I am taking x plus y is equal to 50, equation number 1, x plus 25 is equal to 50, so x is equal to 50 minus 25, so x is equal to 25. Okay, so this answer is 25 25. D is the correct answer. Okay, next question C. The father's age is 6 times his son's age. The father's age is 6 times his son's age. 4 years hence, the age of the father will be 4 times his son's age. The present age in year of the son and father are respectively. Okay, so first we will consider, let the son's age is equal to x, father's age according to the question 6x, 6 times it is given. Okay, now what they have told us, 4 year hence the age of the father, 4 year hence means 6x plus 4, age of the father will be 4 times his son's age at that time. So if we are adding 4 year, after we are thinking about father after 4 years, then we need to think about sons also. So x plus 4. Okay, so 6x plus 4 is equal to 4x plus 16. So after that, 6x minus 4x is equal to 16 minus 4. 6x minus 4x is 2x is equal to 12. So x is equal to 2, 6 are 12. X is 6. So what will be father's age? Father's age will be 6x. So 6 multiplied by 6 is 36. So 6 and 36. So option C is the correct answer. Okay. Then next is C. Question number 21. X by 2 plus x by 4 plus x by 5 plus 1000 is equal to x. 10,000 is equal to x. So here what we will do? We will find out LCM of this. So LCM we will is 20. So we will multiply here by 5, 4 are 20. So here also 4. Here 4, 5 are 20. So here we will multiply by 5. Here 2 tens are. So here also we will multiply by 10. So I will get here 10x plus 5x plus 4x divided by 20 plus 10,000 is equal to x. So 10 plus 5, 15 plus 4, 19x. Okay, so 19x, this 20 I will multiply here, 10,000 into 20, it will be 20,000. Okay, is equal to 20, I will multiply here, 20x. So 19x will go there, 20x minus 19x, it will be x. X is equal to 20,000. Okay, x is equal to 20,000 is the correct answer. Okay, now question number 22 is, the present age of father is 4 times the age of his son. After 10 years, age of father will become 3 times the age of his son. Find the present age of son. Only son we have to find out. Okay, so son's age we will consider. Let the son's age, I am showing here in short, x. Father's age will be, father's age 4x. Okay, so according to the given question, the present age of father is 4 times the age of his son. So x and 4x, so after 10 years the age of father, means age of father will be after 10 years, 4x plus 10 is equal to, will become 3 times the age of his son, 3 times the age of the son after 10 years. So we need to add 10 here. Okay, so 4x plus 10 is equal to 3x plus 30. So 3x will come this side, 4x minus 3x, x, 30 minus 10, 20. So son's age is 20. Okay, now question number 23, see carefully everybody. A steamer goes downstream and from one point to another in 7 hours. It covers the same distance upstream in 8 hours. If the speed of stream be 2 km per hour, find the speed of the steamer in still water. Okay, so first we will consider here see, speed of steamer is equal to 2 km per hour. ओके मीन स्टीम स्पीड ऑफ स्टीम इज 2 किलोमीटर पर आवर, देन स्पीड ऑफ स्टीमर इन स्टील वॉटर, वी विल कंसिडर एक्स किलोमीटर पर आवर. ओके नाउ आफ्टर दैट एक्स किलोमीटर पर आवर डाउन स्ट्रीम एंड अपस्ट्रीम, व्हेन स्ट्रीम इज इन डाउन स्ट्रीम दैट टाइम्स ऑलवेज स्पीड इंक्रीजेस. ओके सो डाउन स्ट्रीम स्पीड इज इक्वल टू एक्स प्लस टू. ओके एंड अपस्ट्रीम द स्ट्रीम विल गेट रेजिस्टेंस, सो डेफिनेटली स्पीड इज गोइंग टू डिक्रीज. तो सो अपस्ट्रीम इज इक्वल टू एक्स माइनस टू. वी नो दैट स्पीड इज इक्वल टू डिस्टेंस अपॉन टाइम, ओके सो डिस्टेंस इज इक्वल टू स्पीड मल्टीप्लाई बाय टाइम. ओके सो अकॉर्डिंग टू दैट हियर इट इज गिवन सी इफ द इन 7 आवर्स अ स्टीमर गोज डाउन स्ट्रीम फ्रॉम वन पॉइंट टू अनदर इन 7 आवर्स. ओके सो डाउन स्ट्रीम इट विल बी एक्स प्लस टू, सो 7 आवर्स, सो वी विल मल्टीप्लाई हियर बाय 7 × x + 2. ओके स्पीड मल्टीप्लाई बाय टाइम, टाइम एंड स्पीड वी हैव मल्टीप्लाइड हियर. ओके द सेम डिस्टेंस इट विल कवर, इट कवर्स द सेम डिस्टेंस बिटवीन इन 8 आवर्स बट अपस्ट्रीम. सो 8 × अपस्ट्रीम व्हाट इज द डिस्टेंस, व्हाट इज द स्पीड, x − 2. सो x − 2 एंड टाइम इज 8, बोथ आर सेम बिकॉज डिस्टेंस इज सेम. वी आर कंपेयरिंग नाउ डिस्टेंस. ओके सो नाउ वी कैन सॉल्व दिस, 7x + 14 = 8x − 16. सो नाउ आफ्टर दैट 7x − 8x = −16 − 14. 7x − 8x − x, सो इट विल बी −30. सो x = 30. सो आंसर इज 30. ओके नाउ नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज 24 क्वेश्चन इज हियर ओनली. फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ k इफ x = 2 and y = 1 फॉर द सोल्यूशन फॉर द इक्वेशन. सो क्वेश्चन नंबर 24 सी, वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट वैल्यू ऑफ k x = 2 and y = 1 इज द सोल्यूशन ऑफ द इक्वेशन 2x + 3y. 2x + 3y इज इक्वल टू k. जस्ट वी हैव टू पुट द वैल्यूज 2 × 2 + 3 × 1 इज इक्वल टू k. 4 + 3 = k. सो k इक्वल्स टू 7. सो 7 इज द करेक्ट आंसर. एंड लास्ट क्वेश्चन सी, 5x दैट आई एम टेकिंग हियर, 5x + - = 13 इज द सोल्यूशन, हैज द सोल्यूशन माइनस 3. ओके सोल्यूशन माइनस 3 मीन्स दिस इज द वैल्यू ऑफ कोई वेरिएबल विच इज गिवन हियर. सो 5 × −3 + - = 13. सो 5 × 3 = 15, −15 + = 13. सो −15 विल गो देयर. सो 13 + 15 = 28. ओके सो दिस वॉज वेरी सिंपल पेपर, वेरी इजी पेपर. ओके आई थिंक यू हैव अटेम्प्टेड वेल. थैंक यू वेरी मच.